Hello everyone. Welcome to 7. A CME is heading for Earth following the eruption of a magnetic filament during the late hours of July 28. NASA's Solar Dynamics Observatory recorded the liftoff. A coronal mass ejection is a significant ejection of magnetic field and accompanying plasma mass from the Sun's corona into the heliosphere. CMEs are often associated with solar flares and other forms of solar activity, but a broadly accepted theoretical understanding of these relationships has not been established. If CMEs smash into Earth, they can cause geomagnetic storms, disturbances in our planet's magnetic field, that can trigger partial radio blackouts and produce vibrant aurora displays much farther away from Earth's magnetic poles than normal. Earth has already been hit by 5 G1 or G2 geomagnetic storms this year, including the most powerful storm for more than 6 years. These storms have superheated the thermosphere, the second highest layer of Earth's atmosphere, to its highest temperature in more than 20 years. The number of sunspots is also increasing as we approach solar maximum, reaching its highest total for almost 21 years in June. Near solar maxima, the Sun produces about 3 CMEs every day, whereas near solar minima, there is about 1 CME every 5 days. On July 28, NASA's Solar Dynamics Observatory recorded the liftoff. CMEs typically reach Earth 1 to 5 days after leaving the Sun. Shortly after the eruption, SOHO coronagraphs saw a faint, lopsided halo CME emerging from the Sun's southern hemisphere. A NOAA model of the CME shows it hitting Earth on August 1. The impact could cause G1 to G2 geomagnetic storms with high-latitude auroras.